Hi, this is Chrisferb, and I'm going to review a Poisson distribution example. Okay, a book publishing company has determined historically its books have 1.5 errors per 100 pages of print. What is the probability of having zero errors found in 100 pages? Okay, so this is a Poisson distribution probability distribution problem. And the way that a Poisson formula is usually written is like this. We have lambda, and lambda is essentially what our average expected is for this, multiplied by the time, and then x, which is what we're looking for. Then E, which is natural log, which I'll explain. It's 2.7 and then goes on essentially forever. And then to the negative exponent of log to the T exponent multiplied. So what I do, we have X to the factorial. So what I do is I use a Poisson parameter when I do this. So the formula that I always use is this, and I'll write out kind of the way it looks. We're looking for zero within our time frame. So what I do is I usually do this. I have mu, and mu is lambda times t. So I have mu to the exponent of x, and then e the negative exponent of mu, and then x factorial. So what I do is I clean up this part where we have the lambda times t. So I make it one package, and we call this mu, and it's a Poisson parameter is what they call it, and some people use it, some don't, but that's kind of what I do. I think it's easier for a couple reasons. One of them is once you calculate it all out, you just plug in your mu, and it just makes for simpler calculations. Okay, we'll get started. Okay, so we'll write out what we know. And what we know is lambda is 1.5 errors per 100 pages of print. And it says, what is the probability of having zero errors found in 100 pages? So we're in the same, essentially, the same range. So So that makes it really easy for us. So we're going to write out 1.5. We don't have to do any conversion is my point, and I'll explain that. And so because we're in that same range of 100 pages, both 100 pages is the range or the interval that's what I'm looking for, the interval that we're working with, and we're looking within 100 pages, so our interval is the same. Then our time that we're within is just one. So we're not making a modification to that, okay? And then our E that I was talking about, the natural log, it is 2.718. I never know because I just used the key in the calculator, which I'll explain in just a sec. So then our X that we're looking for is zero, because we're looking for zero errors. And the Poisson distribution is the certain amount of, you're looking for something within a certain interval of time or distance or whatever the interval represents. Okay, so let's work this out, and we're working out this formula right there. Okay, so we'll plug everything in. And when we plug everything in, we end up with 2.718, and then that's the negative of 1.5. I kind of ran out of space. It's okay. It looks like it's showing up okay on the camera. 1.5, and then down below, we're looking for our x. Now, when we work out the factorial of zero factorial, it ends up being one. So that's kind of what it works out to be. Okay, so let's, when we do the math, we end up with this. Our answer is 0.2231. And when you do the math, I recommend doing the top portion first, or doesn't matter, but do the top portion, the bottom portion, and then go and divide it out. Try not to do it all in the same one calculation on your calculator. If you don't have parentheses set up properly, then you end up with some errors just with the order of operations. Your calculator, when you think about it, you would think your calculator is really smart, but when it comes to certain things such as exponents and things like that, it actually doesn't do a very good job, especially with negative exponents. Okay. So this is what our answer is. So zero errors found in 100 pages is 0.2231, or about 22.31%. So let's do this on the calculator. If we do this on the calculator, what we do, and I'll pull up the calculator in just 1 second. So on the calculator, we go to the second. And the second is just the part that makes it so that our accessory, essentially the alt of our keyboard on our TI-83/84 functions work. So you push in second, and then it's distr, which is for distributions, okay? And then we go to Poisson PDF, and it's PDF because we're looking for a specific value, okay? And within that, it's very easy, and then I'll pick up on the calculator. So on the calculator, we do second, and then distr is right here on my calculator. Then we go down. Now, if I go up, it'll bring me to the end of the page, or I can just scroll all the way down. I sometimes go up, which brings me to the bottom here, and it brings me right to the Poisson PDF. Okay, so Poisson PDF, hit enter. And like I said, this is very easy. Now, for our lambda, we want to put in our Poisson parameter, which was our mu that we worked with. So for us, we put in, it's the same either way, because when you multiply 1.5 times 1, we get 1.5. But if this was different, which it will be in later calculations, you put in the mu calculation, and not just the lambda, but the lambda times the t. For lambda in the calculator. So I'm going to put in 1.5 and then go down, and then our x value is 0. Okay, so it's really easy in the calculator, and then hit enter. And so you see now, if you have a calculator where you have to put in, it just brings you up with a open parenthesis, you have to put this in. So all that means is you need to remember where the variables go. And that's where I would write out kind of the way the variables go. And so this is for some of you, it's like this. So it's Poisson PDF, and then it is our lambda, or it could be our Poisson parameter, comma. You have to put in the comma. My mouse is right there in the way. And then our x, okay? And then you hit enter. You have to put the closed parentheses, otherwise you won't get the answer. You'll get an error. Okay, I'm going to hit enter, and I received 0.2231, which is our answer. It's the same one as we received by working it out. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed that, and in future Poisson examples, in the last one, I'm going to go over how you do some of these problems, especially the Poisson example 1 problem in Excel, so that will be covered as well. Thank you.